I have to apologise in advance. It's not. I'm not in the best shape. I'm kind of sick, so please bear with me. So if I'm passing, I'll just drag me from the stand. And there's more CIB people in the room, so they can take over from me. Okay. How's it looking? Did everyone get this questionnaire? So you should have one in your in the conference program. If you don't have one now, there is a step still. Go grab one, fill that, return that. You can come to any of those guys with this T-shirt and hand it in. We're really interested in your opinion. Just fill out what you feel comfortable filling. Okay. With that out of the way, welcome, also from CIB side, to the conference. This is about, predominantly this is about CIB. What are we? How did we get into this project? How did I get into this room? Since, well, I think most of you don't really know the company. We've been the sponsor of last year's conference, but only since about 6 months been really active in the Liberal Office project. So, yeah, who is CIB? Well, it's a medium-sized company based in Germany, or founded in Germany, but older than 25 years. And since about 2009, it's been looking into open source in general and open source office applications in particular, and also open standards. That there was renewed interest into that topic, of course, after the Oracle IBM story, and particularly after it became apparent that IBM might be leaving. CIB lives to make lives easier for companies and, of course, municipalities. We also count among our customers. And we want to help reduce license costs for people, regardless whether that's banks or insurances. Banks actually are right now rather in a crunch because of the very low interest rates. So the classic income stream for banks, just adding the margin on top of the interest, that's a bit in danger. So there's, especially among our core customer base, there's real interest in reducing costs, and that includes licensing costs. That's really the sort of customer we want to appeal to. And it's regardless of whether that's natural convicts, like for example the city of Munich, that we're happy to serve for LibreOffice, or banks or insurances, which are really not so much into the ethos of open source, but rather interested in reducing their cost of operations. Beyond that, we strive to unite IT process know-how and with professional expertise. And that's actually how we earned the trust of our known customer base, which is, for example, Deutsche Bank, UniCredit, and total more than 1,000 financial institutions, insurance companies, and lots of German municipalities. Yeah, that's mostly about set. Of course, what also I'd like to stress is that SEP is really known for its proven ability to deliver on time and within budget. So I think all of you that already had the pleasure, we had the pleasure of having business with, have experienced that. So, among our customers, SIP is appreciated for innovative solutions. For example, we have browser-based viewers and zero footprint installs just a nice plus when you look at banks and municipalities in terms of security and maintainability. We also have about 60,000 deployments with banks and hotels for kiosk modes, where we have, that's also zero install solution that we're providing now. Another example, I talked about that with my colleague Vasily yesterday, JS Merge. That's a tax programming software which is OEF based and which permits you to dynamically program fields to generate OEF out of it. With such dedicated tools, the core product is RTF based. That service providing to most of the customers. And with that, that's pretty much a mail merge on steroids, so it's a breeze to generate 200,000 letters in an instant out of that and go and print that. That's where SIP is market leader, at least in Germany. And in the financial sector, and we're doing output management for a number of mass mail processing plants. So it's, I don't know if you've ever seen those. It's like you put a big, like 5 tons of paper into one side, and then the other side comes out whatever invoices, account statements for your customers. So we have about with that mass production. SIP software is involved in generating about 500 million pieces of printout per year in Germany. Another thing that we really feel strongly about is that we want to protect investments of our customers. That's really crucial. Just to give you some idea, with the one of the cooperative banks in Germany, they have about 600,000 templates that go into their processing chain for generating output. That corresponds to about 100 person years of investment that have been made into that setup, and that's running on SIP software. So with that number, it's really important that the investment is secure and customers trust us on that. So, there is that slide that I forgot to show. That's pretty much what I just said. I'll spare you the repetition. That's just the numbers again. And at least, as I say, in Germany, we're the market leader there. That's where CIB comes from. That's our history. Now you will probably ask, what's the story with LibreOffice? How did we get into that? So for that, let me open with a little of provocative question. Why is it that? What do you think? Why is it that a single office suite from a well-known company in Redmond is so dominant among companies and municipalities? I mean, can't those people do the math? Obviously, it's more expensive, it's feature-laden to the point that you don't need, usually you don't need 90% of the feature set. So why is that? I mean, can't decision makers just do the math? And if you look at the history of the statistics, then obviously it's the case that the market share is even shrinking from 2011 to 2013. The answer probably is that surely they can, but predominantly when you look into business investments, first and foremost, you want to protect your investments. You want to be sure what you spend today, when you put your head on the line, that this investment is safe in 5 years, and 6 years. And there was some insecurity. I mean, this lit among the open office space projects really didn't help in generating trust that whatever happens, it will be there 5 years from now. But I'm having high hopes that this is now increasingly obvious that this is settled, and I'm very positive that the outlook is clear and that trust will grow or come back. So with that, the prospective market share of 2016, we just put that there. But I think it's achievable. As I say, I'm in the opening speech, I think this is a bit of a pivotal year. So lots of things falling into place, lots of domino pieces falling. And once you have critical mass and certain, like Italy is the best, probably the best example, once you have critical mass in an environment, it's much easier to convince others to follow. Because that's among the reasons why it's this old IBM problem. So no one ever got sued for buying IBM, or in these days it's more like no one got sued for fired for buying Microsoft or SAP. And that's why people choose like so. For the central question behind that is, of course, when I pick a supplier, will that supplier be able to pull the migration off in time and in budget, and will day-to-day operation work going forward? So every change bears a risk, so migrating to LibreOffice is a risk, and therefore predominantly when you decide to go that route, it's predominantly a question of trust into the project and into your partner for the migration. So, again, why is CIB here? We're doing open source and open standards with a passion. Those are not empty words, that's convictions, and we, one of the ways we show that is that we are sponsoring this conference, we're sponsoring TDF, we're sitting in the advisory board for TDF, we're a member of OASIS, we're a member of the Open Source Business Alliance. At OASIS, we will be doing our share. We're looking into standardizing this ODF-based text programming that we presented yesterday. And on CeBIT next year, CeBIT 2016, we will be there with a booth and putting LibreOffice into spotlight again, and invite you to join there. TDF might be there as well, either on a separate booth or at CIB booth. Just be lovely. CeBIT is still the largest IT trade fair of the world, so it's good to have you represented there. Additionally, of course, we're quite open-minded, so we also help other open office based customers or other open office based deployments to migrate to LibreOffice. We help Adobe customers have been let down by Adobe kind of taking out PDF XFA support. And we have a number of references. So we helped one customer insurance company with 10K seats on short notice to fix one rather large deployment will occur within days. So, what else is to say about CIB? One additional area where CIB is investing is research and development. So it's not necessarily all the revenue generating on day one. just a number of examples from the past 5 years, which totaled about 10 million euro of investment in general research, general development tasks. One example is the DER project. It's a cooperation with Fraunhofer in Germany. The goal there was to do image processing, image recognition tasks on colored grayscale images, exclusively on smartphones. So all of that logic, all of that intelligence would be running on a smartphone. In contrast to other, Google, Apple, all of them just do the detection or the picking up the data and then sending that to some cloud service doing the processing there. On this project, it was really running it on the phone exclusively. There's another cooperation with the University Gran Canaria of Las Palmas. That's about pure optical data transmission between mobile phones. Another topic is PDF universal accessibility and Doxybox. That's a scanner, ad hoc scanner setup, and that's really nice and helpful for blind or visually impaired people to get their documents processed. So, LibreOffice powered by SIP. That's the brand, that's the name of the product that we are happy to tell you more about. So please come to us and talk to me or to one of my colleagues. LibreOffice powered by SIP, that's a strong statement and that we actually stand behind. So we will support a future with an even more interoperable LibreOffice that can run in a browser. We already have 8 core developers working for CIB, 4 of them certified. And you can add to that our experienced team of support professionals and consultants that bring more to the table, for example, in terms of streamlining business processes, looking into other opportunities. So, doing our share in the community is very close to our hearts, and our mission is to carry open source into our rather numerous customer accounts and the municipalities. And as such, we consider ourselves door openers for the LibreOffice community. And quoting one of the German co-op banks' mission statements is we clear the way. I would really like to do that, we'd really like to live that mission. So with that, we invite you to join and be that as a partner, customer, or even as an employee. So we still have openings. Okay, last slide, so we can slowly start to wake up again. Yeah, migration. I mean, that's where really most of the market is. I mean, there's those that have already seen the light, that are already running open source, that are already running either LibreOffice or OpenOffice already. But the vast majority of the market is still running Microsoft. So that's where we really like to go into. That's where we like to convince people that it's worth it. We would like to convince people that they can trust us. And we'd love to push LibreOffice much more into enterprise deployments. Incidentally, there's a question I'd like to ask you. Back in the day when this new Microsoft UI came out, it was kind of new and off-putting to most of the people, but that's how old is that? That's like 8 years in the past. So by now, it has probably become the de facto standard again. And I wonder if it wouldn't be worth looking into CIB and all of you from the community, if we can't get LibreOffice a bit closer to the Microsoft Office UI again. And I'd like to extend the invitation to talk about opportunities there. CIB would certainly be up to help and push that. I mean, after all, LibreOffice does not only need enthusiastic supporters. I mean, that's what really makes this, sets us apart and makes us different and makes such an outstanding community and project. But also we need references in the business arena, and we need leaders in the business market that don't go for LibreOffice because it's open source, or because they feel enthusiastic about that, because it makes economic sense. Of course, all of that is to win new deployments, to win new customers. And with that, I hope I haven't bored you to death just yet, and wish you a wonderful conference. Thanks a lot for your attention. Thanks a lot for being here. Thanks a lot for supporting LibreOffice. Thank you.